Hey guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 12 and 13. This is the first time in a long ass time of the Monogatari series off and Monster. Okay, so because of everything, what has happened this last freaking week? The hurricane coming and work. just for today, for this series, and also with Blue Exorcist season 4 or 5, I believe. You're just gonna get the first two episodes together for now, due to with all the freaking crap that has happened, because I have to catch up on so many things. So much ish has happened between last week and this week. It's just super annoying. I hate the fact that like almost 2-3 weeks I was not able to record for so many different reasons. Either hurricane, tired from work, or I had to postpone due to something, or I was doing a last minute podcast and trying to catch up with it, which I'm still doing. So hopefully my goal is by tomorrow night I am completely caught up. Thank God I don't have to go to work until 10. So hooray. Other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode 12 in 3, 2, 1, go. Did she have her little kitty feet? For now. Okay. God. Excuse me. Pretty. You're right. Seriously? VS? See. Okay. Felice Campbell. Hopefully there's no one named that. Up. Okay. Of course. Oh. They all had short hair. True. All right. There was a fan club for Kambaru? And let me guess, all the girls who died. Yeah, I mean, you've been working your ass off, so you deserve some sleep. Damn, look how tall she got. True, you're right about that. I still think she would be targeted because she was in the fan club, essentially. Excuse me. Me when I come home. Who's calling? Who was calling? That'd be Guy in there. True. You ain't gonna drown her in it. Yeah. The fact that they're going back on like every picture? Oh my god. Damn, that looks beautiful. Oh, good question. Can you answer that? Because you were human before. already got a bad feeling about this. This is the one thing you don't fucking do. But we're doing it anyway, huh? A little scared about what the hell is about to happen. Have their little kiki, and you know, because duh, they need to know what they've been doing after like 600 years and such, and I love that, but I'm a little scared because the shit that these two could do together, even though like Agarai has the hold on Shinobu, but still, you never know what Depth Trope is capable of. Like, she could instantly kill him, and then we all be sitting here like, oh shit, like, damn. I wonder how this is going to go in this next episode. But no, this was the fact that I missed this last week. I mean, like, it just feels like this is finally happening for these two. And hopefully going into the next episode, we do get to see them, like, have a little chance and moment to talk and stuff. And be like, oh my god, how are you? How has it been the last 600 years? Yada, yada, yada. What you been up to? Oh, yeah. Also, who's trying to, like, you know, confirm you for murder? Murdering all these girls and such? Like, yeah, what's going on? Also, here's my biggest thing. And I talked about this in the podcast last week. I'm going to say this. Where the hell is Central Hada during all this? Where the hell is Hanekawa during all this? I mean, yeah, like, yeah, they probably going to their own college and doing ish. But why are they not in this arc? I mean, the last time that we got to really see or hear of these two, especially Senjata, like, it's been a couple of episodes. It's been about a good 5 episodes since we last heard her speak. And that was only for, like, 2 seconds. Hanekawa ain't even in this at all. And I'm pissed about that because they are my two best girls. It feels so fucking weird not to have them both in here. So what the fuck are we doing, show? Because a girl's gotta fucking know. Please, let me know. Let me know. Please and thank you. But yeah, go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 13. Alrighty, episode 13 in 3, 2, 1, go. Your little gal pal is just chatting it up. It's so cute. Oh my god. right? Like, that definitely would have been live. So now what? The question is this the last episode as well? He had to do it. Exactly. Shit, I got a bad feeling about this. Okay, that's all. Not gonna try to do anything? Okay. Well, oh. What? Okay. Yeah. The question is, who buried you? It couldn't have been the high school girl. Okay. Yeah, you would bury her because, oh, hey, you look dead, so, hey, yo, you gotta go. Okay. But something tells me, okay, let's think about this real quick. You know how all the girls in the basketball team are currently together right now, possibly? What if the girl who was the vampire is with them? Think about that. Walk with me. But remember, where are they right now? You know what the funny thing was? I was thinking about that for a while ago because I was like, okay, you got every girl who has a short haircut like Kanbaru. Eventually, she would try to go for Kanbaru herself. Come on now. They're going to kill a high school girl. Killing the fangirl. Oh my god. Oh. I don't see any blonde haired girls. God. What you doing here? Meaning you need PJs. Oh my God. he's not about to dress as a girl in this finale episode. Okay, so the fact is that one of the girls, who is now a new vampire and such, baby vampire, she's hiding amongst any of these girls. Because, one, you can clearly dye your hair. Two, you can wear contact lenses. So now you're looking at everyone except Kamaru and the one girl who looks like freaking Hotaru from Sailor Moon. Because we already know ish about those two. So neither one of them could do it. So now you're looking at the rest of these girls and secretly you're wondering, who out of these girls is a big ass fangirl of Kamaru? I mean, yeah, look at her. Once again, she ain't my best girl, but I still like her as a character. I think she's interesting, even though I still have problems with my only issue I had with her was the situation of her room and the damn books. That's it. And thinking that, oh my god, she's finally gonna clean her room and those books are gonna like go somewhere and such. That room has never been cleaned since the beginning of this damn series, but that's okay. I shouldn't be talking because look at my room. Look at the clothes on my bed. So shut your mouth. Shut up. I'm going to put them away soon. I just don't know when. I literally have no fucking time, but I need to put them away regardless. That was me last week with the hurricane. I was like, oh my god, I gotta watch it. And now it's like, oh my god, I need to fold up clothes and stuff so that I can get them out of my way. But no, both of these episodes were really interesting and in how they were handled. I love the fact that, you know, Death Trout wanted to talk to Aganaki. I think that was the most interesting thing because, like, yeah, he saved her. He helped her out and such. But I was sitting there thinking, like, oh, she probably wants to absolutely, like, oh, shit, excuse me. She absolutely wants nothing to do with him in this situation. But no, the fact is she's like, you know, hey, thank you for saving me. Let me, you know, let me have this chance to not only hear you out, but let me also explain about this situation. Da 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 da. And then let's get this situation, like, handled. Like, bitch, get that shit cleared. But yeah. It just makes me wonder, out of all these girls who are at this PJ party, who is secretly hiding and pretending to be a vampire? Not even pretending to be a vampire. Pretending to be a so-called regular girl when you're now a fucking vampire. That's when I start looking at girls and be like, hey, you know what? Let's try something. Be like, let me get some bleach. Get some good behind bleach. And if you have to, bleach or something to get hair dye out. And start testing it on each one of them girls. And be like, hey, yo, okay. We're just doing this for science. Science reasons. We're trying to save the world here. That's all. Yeah. But the fact is that Agaraki is going to be wearing possibly girl pajamas next week. It gives feels to Final Fantasy VII when Cloud had to dress up as a girl and such. So, hey, I wonder how this is going to be handled next week. But, you know, we gotta wait and see. But other than that, guys, that was my reaction video towards episodes 12 and 13 of the Monogatari series off of Monster Season. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. Really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Metro Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday. You surely will, because I am off next week, peoples. Because my birthday weekend for the final episode of this series. And maybe, like, I don't know anything else. I mean, hopefully, possibly a sneak peek of maybe a potential next season for this show, because I would like to see where they want to go next with this, but obviously, who freaking knows? We never would have thought that in 2024 Monogatari would have came back, so once again, the sky is the limit for anything else that could happen next. Hopefully next week, just like with Oshinoko season 2 with last week's getting confirmed for season 3, hopefully we get something confirmed next week, so fingers crossed. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.